We are now in a state of martial law and war globally.
Training exercises are becoming an increasingly common sight in many U.S. cities.
Everything is now in conditions for a total war state.
Russian soldiers will be put on U.S. soil by Obama to provide security at U.S. events. That's right, you heard me correctly. As part of a deal signed last week in Washington, D.C., between the Ruskies and FEMA. You know who FEMA is, don't you? The people with the camps ready for you. This is illegal. It's a violation of the Posse Comitatus Act. Whoever signed it for the U.S. government should go to prison.
That kind of ammo that they purchased from ATK, hollow point ammunition, as you had explained, it's designed to tear through human flesh and then expand.
This is not a test. This is an emergency broadcast transmission.
I was in charge. I was the Minister of Defense Coordinator. My job was to man, train, and equip the Iraqi army in Al-Anbar, Najaf, Karbala, and northern Babila provinces. And I can tell you right now, well, somebody had the great idea to get rid of the Iraqi army, so when we rebuilt it, we did everything we could to make it as strong as possible. And I'll tell you right now, Homeland Security would kick their butts in a week. What's happening here is we're building a domestic military because it's unlawful, unconstitutional to use American troops on American soil.
It'd be a lot easier for our government to collect guns and confiscate guns and shoot on Americans if they're not using American soldiers, if they're using Russian soldiers.
So what we're doing is we're building a military. My best friend, who's a SWAT officer in Nashua, who came to Iraq with me to train the Iraqi police, sent me an email with a picture of him in the media on the streets of Watertown, Mass, wearing the exact same combat gear that we had in Iraq, only it was a different color. And the way we do things in the military is called task organization. You take a command, and then you attach units to it in order to accomplish the mission. What's happening is Homeland Security is pre-staging gear, equipment, consistent. What they're trying to do is use standardized vehicles, standardized equipment. I saw a picture in the Boston Globe during the marathon bombing where there was a state police officer, actually there were two officers, they both had identical helmets, flak jackets, weapons, everything I wore in Iraq, only it was all blue. The officer on one side had a big patch on his back that said Massachusetts State Police. Another officer next to him, his patch said Boston Police. And so what we're doing here, and let's not kid about it, we're building a domestic army and we're shrinking the military because the government is afraid of its own citizens. The last time more than 10 terrorists were in the same place at one time was September 11th, and all these vehicles in the world wouldn't have prevented it, nor would it have helped anybody. So I don't know where we're going to use this many vehicles and this many troops. Concord is just one little cog in the wheel. We're building an army over here, and I can't believe that people aren't seeing it. Is everybody blind?
Thank you. Notice in Lil Wayne's God Bless America, America is spelled with a K. America, spelled with a K, is a Russianized name for the United States. The Illuminati's New World Order government that they're planning for the U.S. will be similar to the former Soviet Union's government, but the New World Order will spread worldwide. In the former Soviet Union, the government controlled everything, including finances, which controlled everyone's wages, employment. The government chose jobs for them. Religion, anti-God. The government was their God. Anti-capitalism. People could not work or make money for themselves.
Military minded, lost it, can't find it.
The Illuminati is planning a military takeover or martial law to enforce the New World Order. The Illuminati will cause a financial collapse in America and around the world that will be much worse than the Great Depression. This will cause everyone to be in a state of panic and rebellion.
Some might be surprised to learn that the fate of America's economy has already been determined, verified, and announced by the Obama White House. Yet, it has received scant attention from the corporate media. In 2011, economist Kyle Bass interviewed a senior member of the Obama administration about its planned solutions for fixing the U.S. economy in trade deficit. Among the questions he asked was about the U.S. exports and wages. But the question itself was not nearly as important as the response he received from the senior administration official. In fact, this single seven-word response clarifies everything, explains everything, and leaves little else to discuss. We're just going to kill the dollar. There it is, the entire agenda in one short sentence.
The Illuminati will cause a financial collapse in America and around the world that will be much worse than the Great Depression. This will cause everyone to be in a state of panic and rebellion.
The financial house of cards collapses, and the overinflated stock market plunges into a Great Depression. A financial panic grips the world.
This would justify the government's move for a military takeover. The Illuminati believes in order out of chaos. The more chaos, the more control they will gain as a result. The cult-trained military leaders and people under their direction will use arms, hand-to-hand combat, and if necessary, kill to control crowds.
Sweet land of kill 'em all and let 'em die.
Some will try to run and flee abroad out of America.
Police is looking for me, I'ma hide by abroad.
Many will fight, but Christians are taught not to use violence, guns, or any weapons, because Jesus said those who live by the sword will die by the sword.
Cause I live by the sword and die by the sword.
The Illuminati is using artists such as Lil Wayne and others to prepare the hearts of Americans to rebel. This is why you see many videos with the same theme. During the military takeover, the general population will be given a chance to either accept the Illuminati's New World Order or reject it with imprisonment, torture, or death as punishment. With the New World Order in place, the Antichrist, who will be possessed by Satan himself, will become the world leader by deceiving the world into believing he will bring peace to the world during this chaotic time. During his 7-year reign, he will bring peace to the world for 3.5 years. He will also solve the financial problems of the world, and he will cause everyone to receive his microchip, Mark of the Beast 666 mark. And he calls all, both small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in their right hand or in their forehead, and that no man might buy or sell except he that had the mark, or the name of the beast, or the number of his name, 666. Everyone who takes the mark will have no chance to repent and enter heaven, because the mark or chip will be able to control your mind, total mind control. And the smoke of their torment ascended up forever and ever, and they have no rest, day or night, who worship the beast and his image, and whosoever receives the mark of his name. After 3.5 years of peace, the Antichrist will break the peace treaty and bring 3.5 years of destruction, which is called the Great Tribulation.
My mind's filled with minefields.
Minefields are explosive devices usually used in war, which means there will be war on America's soil.
The ashes fall, the wine spills.
The ashes refers to the ashes of death, which are radioactive particles that fall to the earth after a nuclear explosion. The U.S. has been threatened with the possibility of a nuclear attack for many years. The wine symbolizes the blood that will spill from the people who die as a result of the explosion.
World stops, drops, and rolls.
Stop, drop, and roll is a safety technique practiced during fire drills.
It's Judgment Day or fire drill.
This means the world will be in a state of emergency and will try to protect themselves from the dangers coming upon the earth.
Two fingers to my head, pop, peace of mind. I'll be in the cloud, cloud number 9.
Lil Wayne teaches that if you commit suicide, you will escape the troubles of this world and have peace of mind. But in reality, suicide means you have given up on God and you will end up in hellfire forever.
I saw a butterfly in hell today. Will I die or go to jail today?
On Lil Wayne's album cover, there is a red butterfly, technically a moth. The butterfly in this case represents himself, meaning maybe deep down inside, he believes if he dies, he will end up in hell forever. The only solution to real peace of mind and eternal safety is Jesus Christ. Jesus said, "These things I have spoken unto you, that in me you might have peace. In the world you shall have tribulation, but be of good cheer, I have overcome the world."
One of the things that I think is important, and you and I discussed earlier today, was one of the things we can do. So, for is not only limiting state employees in terms of how they try to or preventing them from trying to enforce aspects of this, but also for example the forced home inspections that I've heard about, but also
it knows the truth.
Yes. Do you think this amendment that you got this draft today would prevent state employees from doing the types of things on forced home inspections, but also limit local governments from trying to end run what we have done so far?
FEMA and DHS signed a contract with Russia to send troops here in the event of an emergency. It's no big secret, but we have new information on what they're doing here. They are buying nearly 600,000 AK-762x39mm caliber rifle magazines, 2 million rounds to be delivered to Camp Stanley in Texas of the same caliber. You also have a little over 500,000 going to the Bluegrass Army Depot. And you also have 9x18s that that have been purchased. On top of that, people are like, well, what about the weapons? They're taking anywhere between 200 and 286 Kalashnikov AK-74 assault rifles.
Emergency FEMA Region 3 alert. FEMA Region 3 consists of Washington, D.C., Delaware, Maryland, Pennsylvania, Virginia, and West Virginia. This alert was sent to us by Senator Sheldon R. Sonstadt, retired of South Dakota State. This is Rev. Michelle Hopkins. Well, here is what the Senator's National Preparedness Research turned up. FEMA purchase orders for over $14.2 million for MREs and heater meals to be delivered to Region 3 by October 1st. FEMA purchase orders for 2 million pouches of emergency water to be delivered to FEMA Region 3 by October 1st. FEMA purchase orders for $13.6 million for MREs and heater meals to be delivered to Austin by October 1st. 9-week training course for UN peacekeepers in CONUS to learn urban warfare. They're learning urban warfare, and they need to learn English and U.S. weapons systems. We're having foreign soldiers learn our U.S. weapons systems. This has been going on since the 4th week of July for 386,000 troops to be completed by October 1st. 2,800 MRAPs must be delivered to DHS by October 1st. No leave will be allowed for U.S. military from September 28th through November 5th, NORCOM yearly training for civil unrest is to be suspended until September 27th to be performed in northeast coastal areas. Date for release of QE3 report is to be moved to October 16th. All DHS agents must qualify with sidearm, shotgun, and AR-15. By September 28th. No mention of yearly less lethal qualification. The sporadic testing of GPS and communication satellites is coordinated for the very first time ever with a testing date of September 29th. POTUS mandates to FEMA and DHS concerning support for metropolitan communities dealing with the extreme climate change must be complete by October 1st. These mandates were issued during the last 3 weeks. Over 300 school systems in the U.S. have determined their 3-day kits for each school and 3-day kits for each student to take with them. All deliveries are scheduled for the month of September. All National Guard units will complete riot control and disaster assistance training during this year's annual 2-week training. All units must have their training complete by September 30th. Daily testing of emergency broadcast system to begin on September 25th and run through October 2nd. Eastern-based Coast Guard units to perform massive group training, usually performed in the Gulf, in the Virginia and Delaware areas. This is a 10-day training mission to begin September 26th. God please help America. Sheldon R. Sonstadt, Senator retired, South Dakota State.
Right now, the cops are banging at the door. It's about 1:30 in the morning. They're still banging on the door.
Law enforcement can be sued.
I told them over and over again they're at the wrong address. They keep yelling out 4663, and that is the wrong address. They are not at the right place. And they will not stop. They have not told me what they're here for. They've been banging on my door since 1:30 a.m. It's now 2 o'clock a.m. They have still not told me what they're here for, and they're threatening to break into my home.
It's harassment. I haven't done anything.
Sir, we're opening the door. Please stop. We're opening the door. Please stop. Okay, please stop. You're being filmed. Please stop. Please stop. You're all on camera. Please stop. We will open the door. We will open the door. We will open the door. Just stop. Who's the supervisor? Lord, please.
Name of Jesus.
Lord, please.
I rebuke Satan back to the depths of hell from whence he came. I rebuke Satan back to the depths of hell from whence he came. I haven't done anything. I'm a Christian woman. I haven't done
anything. What are you doing? You're coming out. We're not doing anything. Please stop.
I am in my apartment, sir.
Go back inside right now!
I am inside. This is my door. I'm standing right inside my apartment. Sir, I'm inside my apartment.
They're learning urban warfare and U.S. weapons systems.